Hi, I'm Kristyn Burtt for Red Carpet Report, and we are here for the 22nd Annual Art Directors Guild Awards. Congratulations. What a week you've had. Double Oscar nominee.
I know. Amazing.
How does that, I mean, really, do you wake up and go, is this a dream? Do you pinch yourself?
No, it was incredible. It was just bizarre and fantastic and thrilling.
Do you know what's wonderful, too, is that both are so different, one from the other. So let's go back and take a look at Beauty and the Beast, which was one of my favorites last year. What did you love about working on the film?
Well, I mean, it was just an amazing thing because it's Disney's beautiful baby, and they gave it to Bill Condon and me and said, make it come to life. And that was fantastic and challenging. And we had a long time to do it, and we had a good budget, and we had a fantastic team, and that was what was heavenly about it. So
does Disney have a lot of say in those little details because they know what they're looking for?
Disney very much know what they're looking for, but they were very hands off. We very much kind of wanted to capture the DNA of it, but we also had to fill in a lot of gaps because obviously the animation is a much more, from my point of view, is a much more simplified image. But it's trying to capture it. But then you have the practicalities of the little critters. How do they work inside that enormous castle? So there's lots of kind of practical problems to solve as well. So, yeah.
I love that. How about Darkest Hour? Totally, like, different feel, yeah. Different type of movie. I'm imagining a smaller budget as well.
Well, don't quote me on this, but I think the Darkest Hour budget overall was about the budget of the art department for Beauty and the Beast. So, but you never have enough. And, but that said, it was a beautiful, fantastic story to make. And again, working with Joe Wright, who I've worked with a lot. So it's like coming home, particularly after something as kind of massive and rolling as Beauty and the Beast, to then go crunch. Right, you've got like 5 months to make this film and no money and no time and, back to how we were really. So
I love that. I love that because sometimes it gives you like an extra hunger.
Yeah, totally, totally. And also it was such an incredible story, a story that I didn't know. I didn't know the details of it. I mean, who knew that we were so close to such complete disaster? So to be able to bring that story to life and to tell it was incredible. So, yeah.
One final question, since we are in the Time's Up era. Yeah. Women in art direction, where do we need the push to get more women working behind the scenes?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a tricky thing. And I think, we start off 50-50 at college or more women than men. And in the early days in the art department. And then as time goes on, we diminish in numbers. And the reason for that actually is because women go off and have children, and it's now actually a case of welcoming them back and making it possible for them to work, be it job share, be it better hours, be it, whatever, to actually try and make it work. And that's the way to do it. So
it's a great point. I love that. Congratulations. Have a wonderful time today.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and in the comments below, let us know what film you would like to live in from 2017.